Do you see that? He says the stone shall be what? God's house. The stone. He doesn't say this place shall be God's house. He says the stone shall be God's house. And in the book of Matthew chapter 16, what did Jesus say? He says, upon this rock, I will build my church. So he must say, upon this revelation. So in the same way, Jacob. So you see, the consistent act is that the house of God was born from a stone. In the New Testament, the house of God is born from a rock. Do you see that? What is that rock? Revelation. Jacob had a revelation when his head was on the stone. Jesus called what Peter said a revelation, which is a rock. And Jesus says, I will build my church on this rock. I will build my church on a revelation. So the house of God is a place of revelation. What is a revelation? It is something you get to learn outside of your physical senses. Jacob's eyes, physical eyes, were closed, but he saw angels. His ears were shut. You know, when you sleep, everything about you is paralyzed, right? But he heard the voice of God. He heard God speaking to him and giving him a covenant. He heard that in his sleep. So that's how revelation, we use that as a symbolism to show how revelation works. Your senses do not participate in revelation. So revelation is you knowing something beyond what you've learned in your school books. It's you learning things beyond what you've read in the newspapers. I mean, when we are able to prophesy and say this and this is going to happen, how do we know that it is revelation? Are you hearing? It is what? It is what? It's a revelation. We get to know